this is Lily Love. And I'm not sure why we named her Lily Love, but we went through a series of names when we adopted her, and Lily Love just fit somehow.
Look at her face to know why we named her Bambi. But the Disney character Bambi the deer looks exactly like Bambi.
My mom had recently watched Sonu ke Titu ki Sweety, and that's why she said we have to name him Titu. And Titu it was.
When we met her, there were these two dogs who used to always roam around together, so we just ended up naming them Kaju and Barfi.
We met Leo through Yoda. Yoda is a NGO that is involved in rescue and adoptions.
So I had this initiative for the welfare of stray animals. It's called For the Fur Kids. And as part of that, we have to work a lot with stray dogs and cats. And that's how we ended up meeting Barfi.
I actually got Cornflake from my local NGO. So I adopted her from Yoda, based out of Bombay.
Thanks to Instagram and thanks to World for All Animals that we actually met Bambi.
This is her favorite pose. She loves to do this all day, snuggling, chilling on her mat.
Cornflake's favorite pastime is to meet kids.
Sleeping on top of my car.
Favorite pastime, I think, is firstly to bug us.
He loves to collect twigs from his grandmother's garden.
The first thing I find is that she's very, very overprotective.
So Lily, the cutest thing she does is when she sits for her biscuits like a little lady.
Cutest thing he does? Titu. High five.
Thank you. The cutest thing that they do is just to sort of be around me when I'm having a not so fun moment, or just to be around when you're feeling a little low.
His most annoying habit is eating on a plate. You cannot sit and expect that Titu will behave himself.
Lily's most annoying habit is definitely to run the opposite side when you call her.
I would like to think it's me.
I can definitely say my dogs like me the most.
He likes the bench, he likes the plants.
Happy mood is always like, yay chicken or yay cheese.
He learned to now wag his tail. And when he's happy, he's all jumpy.
Okay, like her tongue will be on one side and she'll be that's when you know Bambi is going through eternal bliss.
Barfi is sad, she goes into a little corner and you know.
Please me qualify for Lily's sad face. Is it Lily?
Leo, you want ice cream? You want surprise?
So this was when he was 6 months old, we had gone to Pauna. And we took him into the lake and he jumped into it, but like a little child.
It's the first time he swam. So
bringing her home, she's this tiny little puppy, all swaddled up in a little blankie.
The three of us went to Muru recently and she just couldn't get enough of the place, man. She just kept running around all over the place. It was this nice bungalow sort of thing.
I think once 11 years ago, when Cornflake bit on my chappal, is when I was angry, and I think that was the last time. We've come a long way since.
The day before her birthday, or on the day of her birthday, where we were plating, and she would not wait.
Firstly, I feel you should be emotionally, mentally, physically, financially ready, like 100% to 200% ready before you decide to get a dog.
Adoption is a lifetime commitment. You have to commit.
Make sure your entire family is on board as well with the decision. More people on board helps.
I think the most important thing is patience. Patience is absolutely key.
Adoption, I feel pet adoption is a full-time job. People often think they fall prey to cute looking puppies, but the puppy phase remains only for a year. So you have to be ready for what is going to happen after a year.
If you have the heart for it, na, please go, please adopt a dog. It'll be the best decision.
Oh, adoption over everything else.
Yes, yes, I can tell you. It's the best decision ever.
Yes, of course, you know, it's life changing.
I think everyone should adopt a pet.
So you love your pet best friend
as much as I do.
Then please don't forget to watch The Pack on Amazon Prime Video.